Bizzyboxers, expert information on dog training psychology. What is a master and dog relationship?
The great thing about dogs is dogs are really social creatures. If you see them out in the wild or if you see them in feral packs, they form these really, really tight social bonds. So when we take a dog into our house, the dog forms that social bond with us, which is what makes dogs such fantastic pets. Dogs are there going, I love you, you're fantastic, you're amazing. Cats just go, and you are, So I mean, that's what's so great about dogs. So we don't so much have a master-dog relationship as we have a best-friend relationship. And that's what it should be. Your dog's always pleased to see you. Your dog always tells you that you're talking really great common sense, whereas everyone else goes, I'm sorry, you're an idiot. So then that's the whole thing with dogs. It's a relationship. It's not... I want a dog to do things that I ask him to because he wants to, not because he's too scared not to. So I work in a partnership with my dog, and that's what you want. If you take on a dog saying, I'm going to be the master, that just makes you a bully. What you want to do is, I'm going to take a new best friend into my family, and I'm going to help him be the very best dog he can be.
What mental stimulus do dogs need?
All dogs need mental stimulation. If you think of how a dog would live in the wild, about 18 to 20 hours of his day would be spent trying to find food, trying to find shelter, trying to find water, trying to find women, all of those sort of things. So your dog is designed to be thinking and to be working, and you take them into your house and twice a day you go, here's your food, you don't have to do anything for it. No wonder most dogs are bored out of their brains. And that's when you get behaviour problems, and with dogs who are bred to work are just really, really bored. I mean, who says that you have to provide your dog's food in a bowl? Why not go and just scatter it in the garden and say, there you go. And then he can spend, instead of, 30 seconds, my dinner's gone, he can spend 2 hours hunting around trying to find his food. And where is it? Hide it for him. You can get loads of great interactive toys that you stuff with food and then hide them under towels or under plant pots and things. Make your dog work. Make his brain work, because that's what he's designed to do.
How much emotional support do dogs need?
As well as having physical and mental needs, dogs have emotional needs as well. They are animals who live in tight social bonds. And once you take a dog into your family, you have to be responsible for that social bond, that interaction. Now, you're already going to train your dog, and so you build that communication. Everything you train your dog improves the relationship that you have, improves the communication. And that just builds the bond between you. But actually get out and play with your dog. Have fun with your dog. Lots of people forget that bit. We get a dog for fun. So when you go to the park, take a ball, play interactive games with your dog, play games in the house. It's all about just building that emotional bond between you. Dogs are called man's best friend for a really, really good reason.
Why is socialising my dog important?
One of the main things that we can do to make our dogs safe to other people and easy to live with is to socialise them. Dogs are neophobic. Every single animal on this planet, including humans, are neophobic. In other words, they're scared of new stuff. But for a newly born animal to be neophobic would be really counterproductive, because everything's new in those first few weeks of life and they'd be under such stress. So dogs and humans, in fact most animals, have late onset neophobia. So you have a certain period where anything that they meet in that time, they just accept. It might be a bit startling and it might be a bit strange, but just go, okay, that's life. So everything you can introduce to your dog in that early period of life is things that he's going to accept as he gets older. So that's other dogs of all different sizes, all different colours, people, children, toddlers, people with hats, people with umbrellas, people in wheelchairs. Everything that you want your dog to be social to or ignore as he gets older, you need to introduce in that really, really crucial period. Some breeds are really reactive, like your German Shepherds and your Jack Russell Terriers, who are all sort of, and you've got to get as much socialisation in really, really, really early. Other breeds like Labradors and Retrievers are a bit more laid back, and you've maybe got to, maybe 16 weeks, because they're just so like, yeah, whatever. But you have to get every single thing that those dogs are going to have to accept later in life in those really, really early weeks. And if you miss that, you never get it back.
When should I start socialising my dog with other dogs?
One of the most important things is to Check where you're going to get your puppy from, because you want your puppy to come from a place where he has already been socialised, because that valuable socialisation period comes really, really early. So you want to find a breeder who's already socialised the puppies to other dogs in the household, children in the household, different textures. Sometimes they should be on carpet and other times they should be on outside or on linoleum and things like that. So socialisation starts really, really early, and that's one of the reasons why you should get your dog from a really responsible breeder who understands socialisation. And then that continues from the minute you bring your puppy home. Even if they're not vaccinated, take them out and carry them. Show them traffic, show them lorries, show them people playing. Take them to the school gates and show them children. Even if they're diddly little squidgy things, get them out as soon as possible. You never get that time back.
How often should I walk my dog?
Every dog needs exercise. It doesn't matter whether you've got a tiny little chihuahua or a huge big bull mastiff. Everything needs exercise. Some dogs need more exercise than others. Toy dogs, companion dogs, smaller dogs might only need 2 20-minute walks a day. That's enough. But if you've got something that's bred to work and you have the herding breeds, you really need to be giving these dogs lots and lots of exercise. 2 hours free running off lead at least. If you've got a border collie, think what it's bred to do. It's bred to work for 12 hours a day, every day, running across hillsides, thinking for itself. So you have to fulfill the physical needs of your dog in terms of your walking.
What are the rules of dog walking?
One of the main things you're going to do with your dog is you're going to walk your dog. Most dogs, at least twice a day, need just to get out, get some fresh air, get a change of scenery, and depending on the size of your dog or the breed of your dog, will depend on how much exercise they need. But when you're out walking your dog, there's lots of unspoken rules that you just have to abide by a little bit. First of all, always, always clear up after your dog. Really, really important. In some areas, it's a legal requirement, but it is always a social and moral requirement to clear up after your dog. That's the number one rule. And after you've cleared up after your dog, put it in the bin. Don't hang it on trees. There aren't poo fairies. I'm sure people think that the poo fairies come along at night and take away the poo bags. They don't. Put it in the bin. Other thing when you're out walking is keep your dog on lead if there are other dogs around who are on lead. People have their dogs on lead for a reason. There's nothing more annoying if you've got a dog who's maybe scared of other dogs and you keep it on the lead and you're trying to make everything nice when, you know, the Labrador Exocet missiles from hell come flying across and wrestle him to the floor with some owner in the background going, "Don't worry, they're friendly." Not really helping. So you always have to really be responsible when you're out with your dog. Look around. If someone's out with a, you know, tiny little chihuahua and you're there with your bull mastiff, don't let it go and play. You know, I mean, that's just one small mouthful for a bull mastiff. So be responsible when you're out and about with your dog.
Should I always keep my dog on a lead when walking it?
Anytime you're out walking your dog and you're not in a completely safe environment, your dog should be on the lead. Your dog should always be on the lead when you're walking on pavements and walking on roads. And your dog should always be on lead if you haven't trained him to come back when you call him. Some dogs do come back without you training them. If you scream long enough, you know, they're nice enough that they go, "I wonder if she's all right. I better just go and check." But you have to train your dog to come back before you let them off lead.
www.bizzybox.com